Give the highest priority to this tenderness and kindness that each of you bring to your marriage. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do to every relationship at one time or another, focus on what is right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. Let that tenderness be the rule, not the exception. Listen and strive to understand. Remember that you're both on the same team. Together, you will fight demons, defeat enemies, build a life, and forge a bond that is greater than the sum of its parts. And if both of you navigate this marriage with your kind hearts, it will be marked by years of comfort, happiness, and of course, love. And now, a reading by Robert Fulghum entitled Union from Emmanuel's sister, Salome Wheat.
You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those sentences that begin with when we're married and continue with I will and you will and we will, those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken, matter to the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed. Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintances, friends, companions, lovers, dancing partners, and even teachers. For you have learned much from one another in these last few years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
Love knows no boundaries. There are no obstacles that can stand in front of it. Today, all of your family and friends are here to celebrate how your mutual love for one another has not only brought you together, but has melded your distinct families, traditions, and cultures. By promising yourselves to one another today, you also promise to embrace these pieces of your partner and, together, develop new memories with the family you will create. We are all here today to encourage, celebrate, and support the declaration these two people, beloved to us, now make. The marriage they are creating here has roots in themselves, as well as the love, friendship, and guidance each of us have offered them. They have asked us to be here with them today because we are a community of loved ones. We rejoice in the way life has led them to each other and brought them to the place where they now stand. For the declaration of intent. Emmanuel, if you agree, please say I do. Not yet. Do you hear in the presence of God and these witnesses to declare your commitment to Virginia and choose her as the one with whom you choose to spend your life?
I do.
Do you give yourself The couple has chosen to write their own vows. What a special honor for us to listen to your personal expressions of love for one another.
At the end of the day, I can't believe it's here.
Thank you. I wanted to offer you both some advice on how to have a perfect marriage, but there's no real advice for that. Marriage is an adventure full of obstacles and adversity and joy and happiness. The only advice I can give you is how you handle this adventure together will be what defines your marriage. I, along with the rest of your family and friends, offer you the following good wishes on your special day. May your life together be blessed with prosperity and good health. May you always share open and honest communication between each other. May you respect each other's individual talents and gifts and give full support to each other's professional and personal pursuits. May you cherish the home and family you will create together. May all the years to come be filled with moments to celebrate and renew your love. And finally, may your love be a lifelong source of excitement, contentment, affection, tenderness, and devotion to one another. Emmanuel and Virginia, you have consented together in holy matrimony before God, your family, and your friends. You have pledged your vows to each other and have exchanged rings as tokens of your love and commitment to each other. By the power vested in me by the Universal Life Church, in accordance with the laws of the state of Indiana, under the watchful eyes of Coco and Cleo, and with great personal joy, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss me.
is Clyde's. You made it.
Somebody's.
Yeah, it's Clyde's.
Okay. I'll give it to your mom. We made it. Clyde left us up there.
Yeah, okay. I don't know where we're supposed to sit.
Excuse me?
I see. I don't know where we're supposed to sit.
Oh. Shirley. Where is Judy? Like, do they have certain tables for everybody to sit?
I know
she doesn't know where she was or supposed to sit.
Oh, there's some.
Okay. This is tradition.
Oh yeah. It's Emmanuel.
Somebody hold this, please. No, not you.
No, not you.
We did it. It's done. No one asked me for anything the rest of the day. Except for Virginia.
I'm really thirsty, though.
That's the only person I asked me to do anything.
You were beautiful.
I'm married to her, I guess.